welcome back to another Running the Gauntlet, continuing with the Pure Steel theme here. So, as for last time, I decided to add 4 Squadron Hawks to the main deck, cutting 2 Core Firewalkers, an Etched Champion, and the Glint Hawk. And in the sideboard, I put in 2 Timely Reinforcements, and then one of the Firewalkers that I cut. Cutting some of the random swords, which, I mean, they're okay, but I think this deck's got enough swords. Hawk is something I want to try. It might be too slow. I mean, this is a kind of a combo-ish deck, but when you want to grind them out, it's really good with all the swords. So I started to try and run it. Let's go with another 8-man here. I would like to play first. Oh yeah, I'm not mulling this. It's got a priority and a land. I mean, what else can you ask for? Alright, lead with tapped fortress. I mean, this hand's like pretty good. It needs a paladin and some land. But it's got a bunch of action. And a lot of ways to kill stuff like that. So let's find some lands. Preordain. Alright, do not need the husk. Put that on top. Play a land. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to play the flare husk, I think. I'm kind of far away from playing a paladin anyway, so I might as well get this out in order to make it my dispatches a little better and whatnot. Elves, huh? Alright. Well, let's get some action here. Land would not be bad. That is less good, since I can't actually dispatch his Fauna Shaman yet, but I can kill Lenorelf. And pass the turn. Next turn, I'll be able to dispatch Fauna Shaman, so he gets 1 activation out of it. Dispatch should be pretty good against the Mono Green deck, I would imagine. So he can get 1 activation, maybe get a Vengevine or something, whatever. Ooh, another Fauna Shaman. Alright, that's a bunch of dudes. Land. Alright, sweet. I think we're going to go Mortar Pod. And pass the turn. I mean, I'll have effect on his upkeep if he... Well, no. I'm just going to... If I pass the turn and he doesn't activate Shaman, then he gets 2 activations of it, so I'm just going to dispatch his Fauna Shaman now. He's going to activate it, I'm sure. Discarding that to get a Vengevine. Yep. And I'm going to kill Draga Tree Speaker. I guess I didn't need to kill it that instant, but he's not going to be pumping it regardless. So I should have, just blocked Vengevine with it. Now that he's going to Fauna Shaman discarding Vengevine. So I can dispatch, I think I'm still going to dispatch the Fauna Shaman. I'm not that worried about Vengevine. If I draw a Paladin, I can just go off. And even then, I've got Basilisk Caller, Silvok Lifestaff, Mortar Pod, so I can kill a lot of things. But yeah, I definitely should have waited on that particular Mortar Pod shot. Was he just... Ooh, casting Lead the Stampede, hitting... Hopefully just those two? Alright. And nothing. Ooh, if he... Haha, that's awesome. The fact that he waited there is pretty sweet, because now I'm going to shoot the Arbor Elf, and then in response he's going to untap a land. In response, I'm going to dispatch his stupid Fauna Shaman. Yeah, alright. Arbor Elf, not a mana ability as it turns out. So that worked out pretty well for me. He's got a Vengevine, Arbor Elf, and a Copperhorn Scout in his hand. Yeah, Vengevine. Not too worried though. I've got now a sword and a Basilisk Kalar. Alright. Since next turn I get to equip Nexus with at the very least sword and hopefully Basilisk Kalar also. Or maybe Flare Husk, I don't know. I'm not getting hit for too much damage here. And a fully loaded Draga Tree Speaker and a Copperhorn Scout. Alright, so. Sword, equip, I guess I'll play that, play a life staff, sure, and beat down. So he goes down to 1 card in hand. So if I want, I can start killing his guys with, I can kill like a Vengevine or something, but he's got 2 guys in his hand. I think I'm just going to hit him for 3 poison this turn and basically hope to draw a creature next turn. creature of any sort, and I should be in pretty good shape. Or living equipment. Like a squadron hawk would be pretty amazing. I guess I don't need to F6, since I could block something if I really needed to. Alright, so he's gonna play some dudes. Right now he's still got an Arbor Elf in his hand, which not that big of a deal. He gets to bash for 6 if he wants. And we'll see. Another Venge Flight. Yeah, that's a little more problematic. So I can take 10 here. Yeah, I'm gonna take 10. I'll go to 2 and just hope to draw something sweet. I guess, let's see. Paladin would be okay. Yeah, Paladin probably gets me out of this, but not a whole lot else does. And unfortunately, I can attack for 4 poison. That's not quite enough. Alright. So we're looking for Pure Steel. Preordain into Pure Steel might be enough. Definitely don't want that. And now I'm going to have to just draw the Pure Steel. Alright, that's not going to do it. Almost there. Alright, mono green, huh? I think I like this. Time reinforcements doesn't actually seem too bad. I like dispatches. I don't know how good War and Peace is. It seems a little worse than Feast and Famine. Flash Freeze isn't that great either. I think I'd rather have timely reinforcements than Flash Freeze. Counterspells are just not that good against Vengevines and creatures that cost 1. So we gotta cut one more here, probably. Edge Champion seems okay. And maybe I'll just play one timely reinforcements. Alright.